Follow the sun, and which way the wind blows, when this day is done. The cafe has 17 staff. We have two permanent staffs and a carer, and we have a range of disabilities within the 17 clients. They range from mental health to intellectual to physical, and they all do a range of different tasks within the cafe. To see the clients here and to see what they can do with the disabilities that they have, it's a great joy. They're really good at what they do. Really, really good at what they do. I couldn't be happier working in an environment as I do. It's just a pleasure. They're just great to work with. And it's good for them too. It gives them a sense of being involved in something that's good for the community and good for them.
Well, at the moment I'm cleaning tables, and of an evening I clean around everywhere and do the toilets and help take meals out, help wash up. I'm lucky in the sense I've had a lot of jobs before I come here, but some of the guys that work here, it's their first job, and you'd have to experience being with them to see the difference it's made in their well-being and their mental state. It's incredible, really.
I first started here back in 2005. My first job here was a cleanup boy. Yeah, in between it, I've been making coffees now and then, and I'm the main man for the coffee now. So, yeah, customers ask me about if I make their coffees, and yeah, I make their coffees and all and stuff, and yeah, they're like no one else except me. So it changed me a lot, though. It did, maybe. More confidence, and I can use computers and look down the internet and stuff, so yeah, I can use the till and stuff, and maybe, yeah, more better, more happier and stuff, better, yeah.
For me, I've been told by me, my elders, but at the same time, this storyline, what it's called, it runs all the way from the tip of Armidale, right back through where the Gamilaroi starts, right back to the bottom of it. And then basically it's features like, so there you can see it's swimming, and then the outer line where it's in the water, and then the outline again of 2 to 3 parts of the river, like, you know, you've got the river itself, then you've got the outline of the riverbanks, and then you've got the land. So that's basically how this painting is told here, is telling you step by step on how it was formed.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, one of the things, or the principal reason for us being here today, is to recognise the work of one of, in my experience, one of the most inspirational men I've ever known. The cafe provided employment opportunities. He wanted the opportunity to do more, to promote the culture of the local people and of the community in the area in which he'd lived his whole life. Art was one of the really important ways in which Don believed that could be done. We never quite got to manage that while Don was with us, but it was his passion. He sent me a picture with a sign on it. He'd lost the power of speech, but he'd written on the sign, "Carry on," and we did.
What an honour, on behalf of Dad, for the naming of the Aboriginal Art Gallery, on behalf of Nova, for recognising him. Yeah, very proud moment, so congratulations, Dad.
For a long, long time, it's been the only place in town where you can get a nice cup of coffee and a nice meal. And I know, quite frankly, it's one of the few places in Wildert where you'll find a full mix of the residents, from the Aboriginal community to the farmers to people that work in town to the local public servants, wherever. It's the one place in town where everyone mixes together. So that's another a great service it provides. But lastly, for the employment it provides for people who would otherwise have difficulty, particularly in a town like Wellgett, of finding meaningful employment.
You know, often we find in rural and isolated locations there is a lack of things for people to engage in, and I think the cafe's done a great job of giving people an opportunity to get involved and to actually, you know, just meet and somewhere for people to talk. It's so important that people have an opportunity to communicate. It's great that local artists and people who have these talents are given an opportunity by places like this to display their work, and you know, it just certainly adds another dimension to the businesses here in Wellgett, that people can come along and particularly tourists, but locals as well, can come along and see some of the local arts and crafts. It's great.